is the horoscope for Aries for the period between the 20th of May until the 20th of June. So first we start with the Sun, which on the 20th of May will enter Gemini. So during this whole period, during this 1 month, the transit Sun will be in your third house. And basically this is the area which will be the most important for you, the area of your life. This is related with your communication with others, with traveling, with some kind of conversations, and you know, you can initiate different contacts and communicate a lot with other people. And especially when the Sun is in Gemini, this can be related with lots of new ideas that you may have, the desire to share these ideas, and in general to communicate more with others. So basically this is a great month for you in terms of communication and, you know, having new contacts with others. And actually we have also a new moon on the 25th of May, which is also in Gemini in your third house. And the new moon is great for starting some kind of new projects. In this case, for you, this can be related with some kind of new education that you can start, or something else related with focusing on knowledge and actually receiving new information. You can also decide, for example, to travel to somewhere, or you can start something together with your friends, because this is also related with third house. And in general, whatever you start during this time, you can be supported by your friends or by other people, and you may notice that you would like to communicate much more with others. Next we have Mars entering Cancer, which will happen on the 4th of June. Mars actually will enter your fourth house and will stay there for around 2 months. And from one side, this can be related with the time when, for example, you can do a lot of stuff related with your home. You can renovate something, you can repair something. You may need to put a lot of efforts on something related with your home, or to do something together with your family members. But be aware that sometimes the negative influence of Mars can bring some kind of conflict. So this can affect your communication with your family. You should be a little bit more impatient about in your communication with them. So just be try to be more compromising if possible, and just don't push things too much. So as I said, on the other hand, you can do a lot of stuff, you know, like something important related with your home and the place where you're living. So after that, on the 6th of June, we have the transit Mercury entering Gemini and your third house. So basically, Mercury will join the Sun in Gemini and in your third house. So this can be related with even more contacts with others. You can really meet with lots of people. You may feel the desire actually to communicate more with others. Also for some kind of document issues, this can be a very positive transit, and especially for traveling to somewhere. So Mercury in third house is a very positive transit, because actually Mercury is the traditional ruler of third house, so the influence is very strong, and actually Mercury is on the right place when it is in Gemini and in your case in your third house. So for communication, contacts, learning, everything that we mentioned which is related with Gemini and third house, actually this month will be great for you. And then we have Venus entering Taurus. Actually this is on the same day, so on the 6th of June. As Mercury enters your third house, Venus will enter Taurus and your second house. And this is also a very positive transit, because Venus is the ruler of Taurus. So the influence is very harmonious, and Venus again is on the right place when it is in your second house. So it's especially positive transit for your financial security, for example, you can feel more stable in this area. There might be some kind of new income. So in general, things can improve. Of course, when we speak, when we talk about Venus, this doesn't need to be, you know, something really big and huge which will change your life. But it can be some kind of small improvement, like receiving some kind of money that you have waited for, or, you know, finding some new ways for earning money. Also, Venus can be related, Venus in second house, with the desire to have more, to be surrounded by beautiful stuff, to have, you know, some kind of beautiful resources. So, for example, for buying new things, especially if they're related with, you know, something beautiful, something artistic, Venus in the Taurus in second house can be a great transit. After that, on the 9th of June, we have a full moon in Gemini Sagittarius, which will be in your 3rd and 9th house. So this is related, in your case, this axis is related with the plans that you are making. So if 3rd house is related with the, you know, the small step that you need to take in order to achieve your future goals, and ninth house is actually related with this future goal. So basically you need to find the balance in this area of your life. So what are the small steps that you need to take that can you know, lead you to your final destination, to your final goal? And you can change something on the full moon, especially actually the place where the moon is falling in your horoscope can show you the area where you can make these changes. So in some way you may need to, or you may you know, have the desire, you may personally decide to make a change in terms of your long-term goals. So actually think about the future, what you need to do today in order to achieve your final goals. That's what this full moon can bring to you. And after that, on the 9th of June, we have Jupiter turning direct. So Jupiter is in Libra in your 7th house, and a few days before and after that it is stationary, which means that there is a very intense energy related with this planet. So in your case, it's mostly related with the area of relationships. And after that, as we said, Jupiter starts moving forward. So in general, this can bring some kind of improvement related with your communication with your partner or with a close person next to you. Or you may receive support from someone. And in general, things should improve in this area of your life, especially on an outer level. So after that, we have also Neptune changing direction, but Neptune is turning retrograde, and it happens on the 15th of June. So Neptune is on the 15th degree of Pisces, which is in your 12th house. And actually, Neptune is not, you know, very material planet. So actually, when Neptune turns retrograde, it can even be more harmonious. So this is a time when you can focus more on some kind of, you know, private things that you do, things that you do separately, like some kind of spiritual practices if you have such interests, or some kind of meditations. You may notice that your dreams are more intense, more important, more influencing you. So just pay attention on that, pay attention on your intuition. You may receive some kind of important message for you. And in general, you may enjoy more to, you know, to be a little bit more introverted. So this was the forecast for this month. Thank you very much for watching it. And kisses from the mountain. See you next month.